American flag-loving fans just got ultimate payback on NFL player who wore nasty Kaepernick cleats. Since the NFL just doesn't seem to even want to stop the rapid fan loss thanks to the so-called activism of its illiterate ball-tossing employee shenanigans, the powers that be declared that this weekend there will be a My Cause, My Cleats campaign. NFL ball-tossers, who hardly know how to read, write, or speak proper English, are this weekend being encouraged to wear custom cleats to highlight a cause or charity that's particularly important to the player. Most players have chosen cancer and other diseases as their cause, while others have chosen mental issue awareness issues and even feeding the needy. But we all know by now that there has to be at least one ungrateful bum that has to turn this into a political social justice statement. This time it was Richard Matthews, who now plays for the Tennessee Titans but was a former college teammate of the ball tosser Colin Kaepernick while he was attending Nevada. So, of course, he has to take it upon himself to defend the failed 49er quarterback. But as we all know, karma has a way of taking care of business. Matthews must have been devastated when he was unable to get onto the field this weekend with his special cleats because the Titans listed him as inactive right before the game due to a hamstring injury. Via the comeback, Colin Kaepernick isn't employed, primarily because Colin Kaepernick isn't very good. After starting the whole kneeling movement during the national anthem movement, which is effectively leading to the demise of the NFL, the ungrateful spoiled brat who makes $120 million per contract while being a third-rate quarterback, Colin Kaepernick, has now taken to his knees for a whole other reason. To beg for a job. Yup. It's definitely starting to look like no one wants the drama Kaepernick started after he was benched for playing poorly for the San Francisco 49ers last year. I have received multiple notifications this morning from my phone telling me that this has been, never was, is now changing his tune and is promising to stand during the national anthem if allowed to play ball again. Convictions are easy to stand up for unless it affects your pocketbook, right, cop? Poor cop, he tried being anti-American in order to deflect from the fact that he's just not that good, and definitely not $120 million good. But it backfired on him. Now no one wants to hire him because of the mess he caused. Poor thing, maybe he can play for the Somali Football League. I'm sure his girlfriend, who has ties to radical Islam, can hook him up. Is Kaepernick being blackballed by the NFL, or is he not as good as he's been led to believe? Richard Sherman and others are concerned that nobody wants Colin Kaepernick because the outspoken quarterback is perhaps too outspoken. He quietly protested the national anthem by taking a knee when it was played before games in 2016, and now there's a belief that teams don't want that kind of First Amendment exercising in their locker rooms. I can't provide any more proof that teams aren't blackballing Kaepernick than Sherman can that teams are blackballing him. But I do think history indicates that Kaepernick's on-field performance has more to do with his lack of employment opportunities than anything else. Here are the reasons why. 1. Kaepernick isn't a good NFL quarterback. Never really was, although he did take the league by storm, a la Robert Griffin III, early in his career. That was back when defensive coordinators and personnel were still shocked by such uniquely athletic quarterbacks and hadn't yet figured out how to stop them. Then they did, and Kaepernick was exposed. Once the league caught up to him, it became obvious that Kaepernick doesn't know how to hit secondary reads or even consistently manage an NFL offense under center. He misses too many easy passes and bails far too early on promising plays. In his last four seasons, Kaepernick has completed fewer than 60% of his passes, averaging just 7.1 yards per attempt. His 85.9 passer rating since the start of 2014 ranks 25th among 29 quarterbacks who have made at least 25 starts in that span. That is not a small sample. Statistically and empirically, Kaepernick hasn't performed consistently well since the 2013 playoffs. 2. Michael Vick, Greg Hardy, Adam Jones, Alden Smith, Chris Culliver. Vick and his associates murdered dogs, Hardy was arrested for choking his girlfriend and throwing her onto a couch full of assault rifles. Jones pleaded no contest to conspiracy to commit disorderly conduct in connection to a Las Vegas strip club shooting that left a man partially paralyzed. Smith has been arrested at least 5 times since coming into the league. When asked if there were any gay players on his team, Culliver, who also has a rap sheet, once said this. "No, we don't got no gay people on the team, they gotta get up out of here if they do. Can't be with that sweet stuff. Nah. Can't be. In the locker room, man. Nah." All of those guys found work after those incidents, because the NFL is a screwy business in which teams have always been willing to sacrifice moral high ground in order to win. And the better you are, the more likely you are to gain a second, third, fourth, fifth chance. There's no other way to explain why those 5 found new jobs, along with other talented dirds. You know, guys like Michael Floyd, Ahmad Brooks, Ray McDonald, Adrian Peterson, Rolando McLean, Albert Hainsworth, Parrish Cox, Kenny Britt, Aqib Talib, Ray Moluga, Brandon Marshall, Terrell Suggs, Joey Porter, Randy Starks, Frosty Rucker, Santonio Holmes, Kevin Williams, Nick Harper, Tank Williams, Michael Pittman, Mussin Mohammed, Corey Dillon, Rod Smith, and Ray Lewis. If teams were willing to take the PR hits associated with employing those players, surely some would be willing to sign a guy like Pernick, whose jersey sales skyrocketed after he began protesting the anthem last year. Unless, of course, Pernick isn't a good quarterback. 3. He probably thinks he's a good quarterback. I know, Edge Manuel, Kellen Moore, Mark Sanchez, Zach Mettenberger, Brian Hoyer, Nick Foles, Colt McCoy, Josh McCown, Matt Barkley, Brandon Whedon, Scott Tolzien and Ryan Mallett all have jobs, and none of those guys are very good. In fact, I don't think anyone would argue that any of the quarterbacks I just listed are better than Pernick. But that doesn't mean much, because none are viewed as starters, none are paid as starters and none pretend to be starters. They're on rosters as quarterback insurance, and most of them are regular pocket quarterbacks who can serve as a poor man's version of the starter they're backing up. In that respect, Pernick's unique skill set could be hurting him. He isn't a carbon copy of anything. He is the type of player that you build in a fence around if he's good enough. But if he's not good enough, there isn't much of a role for him. Pernick is also a bigger celebrity than every backup in the league, which could have him and his agent seeking a contract that will pay him something at least close to the $14.3 million he made in 2016. But nobody listed above is slated to make more than $6 million in 2017, and most will make a hell of a lot less than that. That same dynamic might also explain why the more accomplished Jay Cutler remains a free agent. But nobody is suggesting he's been blackballed. Pernick isn't very good, but for years he's been led to believe otherwise. In a league where teams refuse to give up on talented turds but can live without semi-talented good guys, that's the primary reason why he continues to linger on the free agent market. Hey NFL, instead of promoting these bums as social justice warriors who give a crap about anything other than themselves and their own pocketbooks, what the NFL should have done is put a stop to this malarkey when Colin Kaepernick first decided, with the encouragement from his Islamic girlfriend, that it was a great idea to kneel during the national anthem in order to deflect from the fact that he's just a piss-poor player and was about to be cut from the 49ers organization anyways. That was the moment to stop it. Now it just seems like the NFL is asking us fans to stay away. It's like they are taunting us with these asinine programs. Share if you will never watch another NFL game again.